Indie Shooter, brought to you by Akidio, Atomos, Band Pro Film and Digital, Blackmagic Design, and Carl Zeiss.
Hi, Clint with Indie Shooter here at the Carl Zeiss event where we're releasing the Supreme Prime lenses, and I'm here with Snehal Patel, and we seem like we just talked a few weeks ago over at NAB, and there was no mention, so you guys have been keeping this a secret, but I assume you've been working on this for a long time. Talk a little bit about it.
Yeah, it's actually been a project that's been going on for years, and research and development and prototyping and testing and all kinds of stuff. And I'm sorry I couldn't let you in on the secret at NAB, but we are officially releasing the lenses this week. So we did an announcement last week on the 24th. We had some events around the world in China, Japan, and in Europe as well. And now we're having an official event, a launch here. It's right before CineGear at the ASC Clubhouse.
At the ASC Clubhouse, and there's been a number of cinematographers that have been utilizing the lenses to do some test films right now that are available on your YouTube page, right?
That's correct. We've had, in the Americas alone, we've had four different reels that we've shot. One was done by John Joffin in Vancouver, called Passing, and then we had a reel done called Ties by Paul Cameron over here in LA. We had another shoot in LA by Laura Marians. She did Weekend Dads, which is a comedy piece. And then we had El Viaje, which was done in Mexico City, and outside of Mexico City by Sergey Saldivar, who's our longtime ambassador and AMC member. So basically their version of the ASC, he's a member of that. So yeah, it's been really nice. And of course, beyond that, we've had another 25 to 30 DPs who have tested. We've had a few DPs that have actually shot commercials with it, including Greg Frazier and Claudia Miranda. So even before the launch, there's been a lot of field work done. We've had the lenses on a Nat Geo shoot in Iceland in negative 30 degree weather, and the lenses did fine. So we really put it through the paces before we were doing the launch event.
Now, talk a little bit about the thinking behind this. It seems to me, aren't these lenses going to be kind of direct competitors to the CP3s, or do you feel like this is something completely different?
Oh, no, not at all. This has nothing to do with the CP3. This is a different class of lens. We're talking about a master prime level lens. So this is your premium cinematography lens for the higher end market. So high end commercials, high end television shows, and light dramas, and single camera comedies, and of course feature films. Because it has a nice clean look, and it has a fast aperture, you can really create any kind of look that you want from it. This is the kind of lens that if you use Master Primes and Ultra Primes before, or even our Super Speed lenses, you're really gonna like the tone and the quality and the look and feel of the lenses. They're slightly warmer than Master Prime lenses. They have a nice soft focus fall off, and most importantly, they have a large coverage. So they cover all the large sensor cameras that have just been released recently, including Alexa LF, large format, the Sony Venice, the Red Monstro sensor, which is also the VV sensor, and of course your Canon C700 FF. So you have a lot of different cameras it can fit on, and of course it works beautifully on any Super 35 size chip. So it works on anything that exists right now and all the new cameras that are coming out. And it matches well with our CZ2 zoom, so you could use the zooms to kind of fill in the blanks if you need some coverage or filling in. We will have the focal lengths from 25 to 100 available first. So there'll be six focal lengths that come out first, 25, 29, 35, 50, 85, and 100. And then after that, it'll be followed by 21, 65, 135, and then 15, 18, 150, 200. So we'll be from 15 to 200 in full frame coverage.
And are they all 1.5?
10 out of the 13 lenses in the series will be T1.5. So from 18 to 135, everything will be T1.5. 15 will be T1.8. The 150 will be T1.8, and the 200 will be T2.1. But really, really close in the T-stops there.
Let me ask you, what about the mount? Are these going to be in PL only?
They will ship with PL, but you'll have the option of purchasing LPL mount if you really needed it. There's no requirement for it because the Alexa LF comes with a adapter that you can use the PL lenses, and there's no difference in coverage from using LPL mount and PL mount at all. But you will have the choice, just like our CP3s and CZ2s, we'll have an interchangeable mount system, so you can change the mount out for LPL. The other option will be Canon EF, and we're also researching E-mount possibility for Sony.
What was the thinking of Zeiss behind these lenses when they were creating them?
Well, we were thinking about the future, which is larger sensor sizes, and then also having a new high-end cinema lens that had its own look. and its own qualities. I mean, it's a neutral look of course, Zeiss lenses would have, and it's nice and sharp, but it has a certain different look to it that's a little bit different than what we've had before. So it's its own lens, essentially. And the market's always asking for this new type of technology, new coverage and stuff like that. So this was a really great basis for us to come up with this. And then at the same time, what about the XD technology? Because this has the same metadata capabilities that we were introduced in the CP3 XDs. So in this version of the lenses, in the Supreme Primes, there is no choice. You get the metadata version automatically. And this will allow you to do shading and distortion correction for visual effects projects. It'll let you do better comps for green screen. It'll give you marks, even if you're a DP that just wants to figure out, what did I shoot with last month? So I can do a pickup shot so I can match my focus and iris and my focal lengths. You can do that as well, because you can have all the metadata automatically in mostly every camera that reads Cook/I protocol. So, which includes Arri, Sony, Red, Blackmagic, everybody, you know, can read this information. So it's a really exciting time, and I think that we were looking, you know, the market really needed something new.
Let me ask you, the availability on these lenses, do you guys have a date in mind? Or?
Oh yeah, we're going to start shipping in August. So we already have a whole bunch of orders, and we've got a bunch of orders since the 24th, since we announced. And we'll start shipping in August, and some rental houses that were our partners that helped us out, they'll actually have the lenses even earlier, like in June and July.
So some of the folks have a rental house that has them, they can go and test them out and things like that?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, people should start asking for them, because they're starting to deliver this coming month, and they'll start being out there. They're already being used or slated for TV show movies and commercials. So, yep, they'll be working for sure.
What is the price point on these lenses?
They're approximately $19,000 each, so they're $18,700 each. And you have to get them in a six-lens set. And later on, we'll sell the other focal lengths in sets as well, sets of three or two.
If people want to see the lenses here in Los Angeles and they're not able to make it to CineGear, you'll have some on hand at the Zeiss facility, right?
Correct. They can just contact me at snehal.patel@zeiss.com, snehal.patel@zeiss.com, and we can set them up with the demo. If there's a cinematographer that wants to work through a rental house, we can set up through a rental house as well. We have premium dealers that will also have access to demo gear. So if you are, you know, if you want to go to our Supreme Primes website and look up dealers, all our premium dealers that are dealing or selling the lenses are listed there. So you can just look somebody up and contact your favorite dealer, or send me an email and we'll figure it out for you.
So Snehal, people want to find out more. I know that you guys started like kind of a new social media for the cinematography division of Zeiss. Talk about that.
Yeah, we have a new social media. Actually, Simone is here, who runs our social media, and she's going to be sending out stories this week as well. But we have a platform on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook as well.
And YouTube too, right?
And YouTube. We have all our videos posted on YouTube and Vimeo. So we're really out there. It's not very difficult to find information. The reels that we're showing at the event today on the screen are also already online as well, so you can watch them. And again, we have a landing page. So if you just looked up Zeiss Supreme Primes and you went to the Zeiss page, you're going to see all this information, reels, tech specs, delivery dates of when the lenses start shipping in the different focal lengths, all kinds of information is there available for you. Size, weight, front diameter 95, you know, everything's there.
Excellent. Well, good luck tonight, and thank you so much, Snehal. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Indie Shooter, brought to you by Akidio, Atomos, Band Pro Film and Digital, Blackmagic Design, and Carl Zeiss.